Dry systems can only be installed on fuel-injected engines that have a vacuum-controlled fuel pressure regulator. If your engine has a vacuum-style regulator, it'll be connected to the fuel rail itself, like on this four-cylinder engine, or possibly to a fuel transfer tube that travels from a fuel rail on one side of the engine to the fuel rail on the other side of the engine, like on this V8. Most regulators are a round diaphragm housing that will have a vacuum hose that exits and connects to a vacuum line of the intake system. The fuel regulator will also have a fuel return line possibly connected underneath it that will send fuel back to the tank. In your kit, there's a vacuum hose supplied and a properly sized vacuum T fitting. Connecting the hoses to the T is simple but very specific. Have a close look at the T. There are two ends that are in line with each other. They both have large openings. The end that tees off perpendicular has a much smaller hole in it. This pinhole fitting is the one that will lead back into the vacuum line that re-enters the intake. Connecting all these lines is easy. Grab the vacuum hose that leads from the intake to the fuel pressure regulator and cut it in a place that will leave some slack on both sides. One of the large fittings of the T should connect to the hose piece that leads to the fuel pressure regulator. Your NOS kit includes a hose that will now travel from the nitrous regulator hose barb to the other large opening in the T fitting directly across from the fuel pressure regulator hose you just connected. Now the perpendicular fitting on the T with the smaller pinhole just needs to hook back up to the other end of the line you cut, which is the vacuum line that leads back into the intake. Use clamps on all the connections because when the system is active, the nitrous regulator will be pressurizing the lines to 50 psi and any excess pressure will bleed off back into the intake through the small pinhole in the T fitting. That's it for the fuel and nitrous regulators, but there's one more piece to the additional fuel of a dry system.
In your kit, there is one component that needs to be installed into the stock fuel system in order to allow for accurately timed nitrous activation and proper fuel delivery. This is the fuel pressure safety switch. It needs to be installed into the pressurized side of the fuel feed line, either by tapping directly into the fuel rail itself or through a fuel fitting downstream of a fuel filter located under the hood.
If your engine has a removable fuel pressure test port on the fuel rail, the process is easy. The test port is called a schrader valve, and some engine designs have a fuel rail that allow you to unscrew the schrader valve from the rail. If yours is this type of design, remove the valve. In your kit is an extension adapter, and with some Teflon paste on the threads, you can spin the adapter into the schrader valve port of the rail, as long as the threads match. Now, with some sealant on its threads, you can fit the pressure switch into place. Hold the adapter with a wrench while you tighten the switch, and you're all set if your engine has this type of fuel rail. If there's not a removable schrader valve on the fuel rail, there are other ways to install the pressure switch. The fuel filter will often have a banjo-style fitting at the filter exit, or you may find a banjo fitting at the fuel rail entry point. Either of these fittings can be considered as tapping points to install the fuel pressure safety switch. You would just need to remove the banjo fitting and then drill a 1/4-inch hole into the center of the fitting. Next, tap the fitting with the 1/16th NPT thread tap from your kit. Now seal the threads of the pressure switch and install it into the banjo fitting. Reinstall the banjo fitting and now your pressure switch will be able to do its job. In the case that your fuel line does not have a schrader valve or a banjo fitting, you'll need to remove the fuel rail and tap into it so the pressure switch can correctly sense the pressure inside the rail. Just be sure to follow manufacturer guidelines to ensure proper removal and installation. With the injectors removed, drill a 1/4-inch hole and use the 1/16th NPT thread tap from your kit to create the threads. Clean out the rail, seal and thread the pressure switch into place, and reassemble the fuel rail.